Today is October 2nd and it's a super special day because it marks exactly 5 years since I moved from Chicago, Illinois to the beautiful state of Arizona. And in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 things that I love about living in Arizona and 5 things that I completely hate about living here, so that if it's a move that you are considering in the future, this is going to help you and kind of give you an idea about what to expect. Or if you're just curious about life in the desert of Arizona, there it goes. 5 things that I love about living here and 5 things that I don't like about living in Arizona. First of all, we need to rewind back to 2016 when I decided to leave Chicago and move here. This move was motivated by a job that I got in Arizona, and it was my first time coming to Arizona, and I didn't know a single person here. So when I told my friends that I was leaving Chicago and live in Arizona for an extended amount of time, they thought that I'm crazy to move to the desert in the United States. So for me, and in my mind, and especially because I didn't know much about Arizona, I always thought that it's a barren desert, the landscape is desert, there's not much going on here. But I decided to move because I needed to move for the job, and also I just wanted to start a new chapter of my journey and my adventure here in the United States. So I moved to Arizona, and in my mind, I am still thinking that it's a dry land. And when you move here, you kind of start to notice all of the vegetation that's kind of unique to the area. The landscape is different, but with time, it kind of grows on you. And that's the number one thing that I love about living in Arizona, is the beauty of the desert and how beautiful the landscape is. There are some of the best sunsets that I've ever seen in my life here in the Southwest in general, but in Arizona in particular, the vegetation and the wildlife is great. The landscape is great. Here in Arizona, there are 3 national parks. There's obviously the Grand Canyon National Park with great and immense opportunities to enjoy the outdoors, like hiking, backpacking, camping, whitewater rafting. And then there's the Saguaro National Park, which is also a great national park to learn about the vegetation in the Sonoran Desert. And by the way, I do have a video up here in which I talk about how you can spend your time in the Saguaro National Park in case you are here in Arizona or if you are moving to Arizona. And then there's also the Petrified Forest National Park, which is a little bit underrated, but it's so beautiful with a lot of history. So I highly recommend visiting the Petrified Forest National Park if you are in Arizona. So 3 beautiful national parks here in Arizona that open a lot of opportunities to enjoy the outdoors. And there are plenty of state parks and regional parks and so many mountain ranges. If you guys have been following me for quite some time, from moving from Chicago to Arizona, you probably noticed that it even changed me as a person and how I picked hiking as a hobby and how I became just so obsessed with the outdoors and going out for camping and backpacking. And this is probably a reason why I even started this YouTube channel, Trekking Pals, which is just incredible. So if you are moving to Arizona, there are immense opportunities for hiking. It doesn't matter what city you are living in the state of Arizona, you will have easy access to many parks, regional parks. You can go mountain biking, you can go hiking, rock climbing. It's just so incredible how great the opportunity is to enjoy the outdoors, which was not possible when I lived in Chicago. The second thing that I love about living in Arizona is the beautiful weather during winter. Now it's the beginning of October and the weather is starting to get a lot nicer. So throughout the winter season here in Arizona, the weather is so very pleasant. It helps you with the boost in your mood, and also it's a motivation to go out and enjoy the desert of Arizona. And we also don't have to worry much about our wardrobe, because since the weather is pretty much pleasant throughout the year, it's pretty much the same wardrobe. And that's one thing that I love about living in Arizona, because when I was back in Chicago, with winter time, a lot of storms, a lot of snow, there is this morning ritual where you have to do a lot of snow shoveling. Driving gets a little bit difficult in the city, while it's not something that we really worry about here in Arizona. The third thing that I love about living in Arizona is the fact that it's affordable compared to a lot of large states, even Chicago, New York, LA, San Francisco. Living here is a lot more affordable when it comes to shopping, when it comes to renting, when it even comes to investing in real estate. I know that things are a little bit different right now with the pandemic, but at least back when I moved in 2016, I could see a big difference about how much money I had to spend for my living expenses in Arizona compared to Chicago, and I found it to be a lot more affordable. I did live with roommates in the past. I lived by myself and then moved to my own home eventually, and I can see throughout every stage it was a lot more affordable compared to Chicago. The fourth thing that I love about living in Arizona is its location and how it's within a reasonable distance from some of the best or the most beautiful states like Utah, New Mexico, Colorado. So if you like road tripping, Arizona has a great location kind of in the middle, and you can even drive to San Diego. For a lot of people who live in Arizona who kind of want to spend some time by the beach, you could easily drive to San Diego. You can also drive to Mexico. We have this area in Mexico, the country, called the Rocky Point or Puerto Peñasco. It's only 3 to 4 hours drive from Metro Phoenix, and boom, you are by the beach. You are enjoying the beach of the Sonora State, I believe, in Mexico. It's just a wonderful beach destination if you are living in Arizona. And by the way, I do have an article in my website. I'm gonna link it right up here. If you want to visit Puerto Peñasco or Rocky Point, I have some great recommendations of food and places to see and where to stay. You can check it up there. But it's definitely one thing that I love about Arizona is the fact that you can just pick your car, you drive for a couple of hours, and you are in an area that has plenty of things to offer. And finally, the fifth thing that I love about living in Arizona is the fact that it's rich in Native American culture, and that's not something that I was immersing myself in when I lived in Chicago. So by way of moving to Arizona, you can see that there is a big influence and there's a big heritage of the Native American culture. You get to know more about the tribes. They do have a lot of sacred mountains and sacred land. You get to learn about those, and that was pretty incredible and pretty eye-opening for me. These are my top five things that I love about living here. Before I talk about the things that I hate about living in Arizona, I want to hear from you. If you happen to live in Arizona, let us know in a comment, what are some of the things that you love about living here? Moving on to the not so positive side of living here. And the first one, which is the elephant in the room, is the heat. It gets super hot from May, I would say, up until the end of September, with June, July, August being the hottest month. So it gets incredibly hot. When I tell people that I am originally from Morocco, and just by way of being close to the Sahara Desert, they think that I have experienced this temperature before. But to be fair, this is the hottest weather or temperature that I have ever experienced in my life. It gets so incredibly hot during summer, especially when you just move here for the first time. You will be so surprised by how hot it gets. You will arrive to the airport, let's say you're flying in, you get to the airport, you open the door, and there's this wave of heat that's going to slap you on the face. And it just makes it difficult, especially during summer, to still have fun while living in Arizona. You can't really go outside and enjoy the outdoors. Sure, there are people who go out and start hiking super early in the morning, as early as 3 a.m. or even earlier than that, or sometimes late in the evening or at night, but it just takes away from, you know, all of the things that you want to do during summer. It becomes a little bit impossible. So unless you spend your time working from home or working in the office, and you definitely need AC, by the end of the day, your options are very limited, and you kind of have to be a little bit creative to find places and activities to do when it gets really hot. So maybe going to museums and exhibitions, but I don't know, I can't think of many options and things to do when it gets really hot outside. What we've been doing during summer, we would try to find or pick destinations that are a little bit away from Metro Phoenix. So you can still drive up to Sedona or Flagstaff, 3 hours up north, and it gets a lot cooler. Or you can drive, like I was saying, to Mexico or San Diego, but the heat, it just kills you, especially year after year after year. I just hate how hot it gets during summer. The second thing that I hate about Arizona, and I know a lot of people might disagree, is food. The food scene in Arizona is a big disappointment, to be honest. I have lived here for 5 years and I've been to so many restaurants, but rarely do I find a restaurant with high quality fresh food. Sometimes you just want some good place with good gelato or good pastry or French pastry. I personally like Middle Eastern and Mediterranean food, and I rarely find restaurants of high quality, which was never a problem for me when I lived in Chicago because food was great in Chicago and there are so many options all the time, while here in Arizona, it's not the case. And even Mexican food, because a lot of people said to me that, oh, there's great Mexican food in Arizona. I don't think that it's great Mexican food here in Arizona, to be honest. Let me know in a comment, what do you guys think? I have been struggling with food in Arizona. It's not the best. Kind of motivated me to spend more time cooking at home, which I do enjoy. But I really wish there were better options to choose from. Third thing that I hate about living in Arizona is the fact that it grows wide but not tall, and it's so spread out. There are so many cities and you kind of have to drive 1 hour, 1 hour and a half, sometimes 2 hours to get from one city to the other, which makes a lot of things challenging. When I was in Chicago, downtown Chicago was the hub. Everyone gathers in downtown Chicago. The majority of the events happen in downtown Chicago, while here, there's sometimes things going on in downtown Phoenix and downtown Mesa and downtown Tempe. There's just not one centralized location where all of people go. And it made a lot of things difficult for me. Sometimes even when you go to events and make new friends and then you realize this friend probably lives 2 hours away and then 1 hour away, it's just hard to bring people together and it's hard to go and meet people. And it's one of the things that I personally struggled with too. I found making friends in Arizona a lot difficult. You kind of have to put a lot of time and energy to make it happen, but that's definitely one thing that I don't appreciate about living in Arizona. Next thing is the transportation and the infrastructure for the transportation system. The transportation system is not reliable in Arizona. There is not a web of trams and trains and buses that you can really rely on to get to and from places, unlike Chicago. And again, I just keep comparing to Chicago because that's where I lived before, and it just makes getting to and from places a lot difficult in here. So if you are moving to Arizona, you certainly need a car, unless you live, you know, across the street from your office or from where you're working, which I did in the past, but you still need a car. I remember back in Chicago, the train system was so very reliable with different lines. There was like the blue line, the green line, the red line, and it makes it difficult to go from one place to the other. And you don't really need the car. I never really needed the car in Chicago, but here in Arizona, it's a totally different story. If you don't have a car, you will feel like, you know, you're just left out, you are living on the edge of the world, and there's just no possible. You can still rely on ride shares, but it gets so expensive. Like I said earlier, it's so spread out, so getting from one city to the other can cost you a lot of money. So that's not so great about Arizona. I don't see it changing anytime soon, because even right now with the construction that's happening, it's still growing wide and wide and wide. There's not just, even with the buildings, you will notice that in Arizona, we don't have a lot of high-rise buildings, some in downtown Phoenix, but it's all kind of flat, low, and it keeps spreading wide and wide and wide. The other thing that I don't like about living in Arizona is that you don't really get to experience seasons. You don't really experience winter as winter and then fall and then spring. Sure, the temperature and the weather is beautiful and pleasant throughout the year, and then there's the summer season when this crazy wave of heat will hit you, but we don't really experience fall as fall. We don't have rainy days, and when I say rainy days, we have the crazy monsoon season, which, by the way, the monsoon season, we have a lot of rain usually around June, and it's just crazy and nasty and sometimes flash floods. But we don't have just a normal rainy day where you can just put your coat on an umbrella and go and have a cup of a coffee, or we have, you know, just like snowy winter days. Although, to be fair, you can still drive up north to Flagstaff during winter and you can see snow and you can play in snow and you can enjoy winter activities like skiing and snowshoeing and snowboarding, but the majority of people are not living in Flagstaff. They are living in Metro Phoenix, and you don't really get that. It's not something that I hate, but I just wish that I kind of just miss the changes in the weather that I used to experience back in the East Coast or the Midwest. And then talking about the weather, we have our dry season during summertime, and when you get super dry, we have a lot of fires. This year, we had so many fires during summer that the national parks and national forests, they had to close a lot of the forests, and so people were a little bit frustrated because you can't go camping when the weather is pleasant, like up in Flagstaff or anywhere really, all of the forests up north. There are so many fires because it's so dry outside. And I know that other states like California suffered a lot of this. I know that the situation right now in one of our favorite national parks, the Sequoia National Park and Kings Canyon National Park, is just horrible right now. But it's just, when I lived in Chicago, it's not something that I even thought about or had to worry about. But you, when you experience it close to you or close to home, it it kind of just hurts, and especially when there's not much that you can do. By the way, I kind of feel like I want to throw this out there about Sequoia and Kings Canyon National Park. They are one of the best, one of our favorite national parks here in the country. If you guys can go to the link that I'm going to leave in the description box and donate to the national park just so that you can help with the current situation, that will be so much appreciated. I know it's not related to the topic, but if you can, please do. And this last one, not that it really bothers me, but I feel like I kind of have to talk about it, and that is scorpions and snakes. It's something that you have to think about if you are moving to Arizona. I remember one day when I moved to my new house, I was sitting in the guest bedroom, just laying in the bed and, you know, just meditating. And then as I lift my eyes, I look towards the wall and I see this scorpion crawling on the wall. I was terrified because it's just not something that I expected. So it's something to think about. And snakes. I used to be so afraid of snakes in the past. I mean, not that they are going to be around where you're living, unless you live close to the mountains, for example. I used to be so afraid of snakes in the past, but now that I kind of spent more time learning about their behavior and just by way of spending time outside and in the mountains, I feel more comfortable around snakes, I would say. But it's definitely something to keep in mind. I know right now when we go hiking, you will certainly see snakes, especially if you are hiking in the heat, especially during the summer months. But I learned that snakes are more afraid of you than you are afraid of them. They don't want anything that has to do with you, really. So as long as you are making enough noise, if you are hiking outside and you're not startling them, you should be fine. So snakes and scorpions is definitely something that you will have to think about if you are moving in here. That's pretty much it for today's video. Obviously, I am still living in Arizona right now, and I have had so many great memories and experiences over the past 5 years. There are days where, you know, I think, wow, it's great that we live here. And then there are days where I'm just thinking, oh, it's probably time for me to move somewhere else, just somewhere where there are mountains, maybe Colorado or Washington. But I do like the States. I think that the desert is so beautiful, and living here overall is not bad. So thank you so much for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. My name is Habiba. This is Trekking Pals, and I will see you very soon on a new adventure.